These digesters are digesters that we call the hybrid type of biodigesters. And the background is simply because you are doing a biodigester for a client at the location. And then after the assessment and everything has been done, you come to the realization that you are going to use prefabricated slabs. And then the prefabricated slab that you are going to use is only 2 feet. That's the length. The only option left for you is to have a block work done at the base of the digester before erecting or placing the slabs on it, which will give you a level that you need enough to get the gradient and then the final outlook of the house to match with it. So what the constructor is doing is he realized that the space is not enough. So he needs to level it up and get enough space to lay the blocks. Make sure the blocks are laid correctly. The traditional way, the way you lay any block for foundation or for any kind of coursework, is exactly how these blocks will have to be laid. And when it comes to the construction of this biodegradable digesters, you shouldn't wait till you get to the site before you make some of these decisions. That's why inspection sometimes is key for you. You should be on the ground to see what you are working with, and then you have to kind of get the understanding of where the pipe is coming from, and then where you are getting your slope from is key. Do you have all the pipes from one side, or are some of the pipes coming from another side, and which one is the lowest point and which one is the highest point? You might need to do it based on the lowest point and then make sure that you are getting a room in the digester for the digester bed preparation, or laying the materials that will give you that room that you might need for your construction. Also, leaving enough room for the wastewater to seep out, or either rapidly, depending on the type that you are constructing, into the Soakhole pit or the Soakaway. This biodigester, we are putting them on the 6 inches blocks, the prefabricated slabs to be erected on them. We are putting the blocks flat so that it can be firm, and then it will not move, it will not shake. Some people usually will want to do concrete work. Others prefer to do the tiling. Better so you can tell, some people prefer to tile some part of the compound and then have some vegetation and flowers and some other parts. So depending on what the homeowner is going to do, you should make sure you have done your work to the best satisfaction of the system that you are building. We are erecting the slabs. We are putting them on the blocks as required. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters. We are a channel that shows you how to construct biodigester and construct them correctly. So go ahead and like this video if you have seen value so far from what we are doing. Go ahead and like the video. You can also leave a comment below and we'll make sure we will reply to all your comments. So they are being held firmly together by the binding wires. When you do cast the prefabricated slabs or the slabs, make sure you have the binding wires there, because that's what will hold it firmly together in place before you can use the mortar to hold the joints, and then they can come in place firmly. The technical guy, the constructor, is checking to make sure that all the angles are right, and that you do this one because you don't want the top slab to come and then some parts will be falling in later, or some of the slabs will come off easily after any activity in the compound. So you make sure you check your measurements, you use your angle bars, and then you check all the corners to make sure they are firmly tight. So he's using the mortar to hold the digester slabs tight and to make sure that they do not move around. We usually call them the hybrid type of biodigesters. So this is the outlet that we are doing, the outlet for the wastewater. It will be leading to the Soakhole pit, and then the leachate pipe was going to be there. This is the inlet. He's doing the inlet, getting it open, and it's going to take out the wire mesh out. Make sure you do it gently if you are using the slabs. If you are using blocks, obviously, then there's also the same mindset. You have to use a chisel to get that space done. And then your inlet pipe is going to go to this particular hole. The level that we are getting is because the pipes are coming from the back, and there's some coming from the right side of the digester as well. There's most of them are coming from the other side. The slope is towards the last end. So the reason we are setting the digester at the lower end is because then it's easy for the plumber to lay all his pipes to this side of the compound or of the property. It makes it easier for gradient work. It makes it easier for sloping. And then it makes it easier for letting the wastewater out of the digester bed through the leachate pipe and then the soak away. We talk about rapid separation or rapidly letting the water out. But we don't want a sharp slope. We prefer a level gradient that will slowly seep the water out. Experience also says that toilet water is the only water that's coming, or the water from the water closet is the only water that is coming into the biodigester. We are not adding kitchen wastewater. We are not adding the bathroom. We are not adding the sink for the brushing of teeth or washing of face or washing of hand. So we can manage the water based on the number of toilet seats or the capacity of the users of the facility. So the screening is being done at the same time as the porous slabs are being laid on the ground. We are using porous slabs in this case because we want extra enhancement. We want the filtrated water to look more cleaner. Make sure you don't break them, because if they do break, then it's going to have an effect on the digester bed when the load starts coming on it. We put the slabs on blocks that we have put on the ground, and then we put the biodigester bed in them. It's all being put together nicely. And then the soakaway or the pipe, the shape pipe, will show up there, and then it will be part of the whole construction that we are doing. In this particular construction, what we did was to do the biodigester first and then leave the outlet there. At a later date, we're going to come and do the soakaway for the digester. We are going to construct a traditional soakaway. We are going to use blocks to have it done. And then I've done some videos that shows you why we prefer homeowners spend extra money to do the traditional soakaway. It gives you an added advantage in terms of the long use of your biodigester. It gives you guarantee. It gives us also guarantee, knowing that if there's any issue that we have to deal with, we know exactly where to go. Unlike the so-called pitch that when you do them, it's difficult to go back to them and open them and have any assessment done, whether it's working or it's not working. For the soakaway, you are going to have a top slab on it, a clean out, an access chamber on it. All these things give you enough access to it for you to open it and see if the wastewater is coming from the digester into it. If you are having problems with your biodigester and you have an access to the soakaway and you open the soakaway and you see that there's no water in it, you know where your problem is. So the first key point for us right now when we do construct biodigesters, and then we do get a soakaway for them, in case you do call us, there's a problem or there's an issue and you call us, the first point is we go straight to the soakaway, open it up and see if there's any water there. So the fiber, after the fiber net and then other things were put on the digester bed, this is the fiber, coconut fiber that you are seeing. This is going to help with the biodegradation. It's going to make sure that the human waste is biodegraded by the use of microorganisms and enzymes that will be generated by this system. Your biodigester is almost done. You are making sure you are putting enough fiber, coconut fiber on it. Make sure all the angles, all the sides do have some. The inlet pipe is also being fixed. The inlet pipe is solely, most of the time, done for the plumber to bring the pipes from the house to come and then have it connected to the biodigester pipe. Now we have the top covers going on it. The top covers will have to be matched to the slabs. And then depending on the number that you have or the sizes, it can be 3, it can be 2. You fit them nicely on them. And then you are going to have to sew them airtight. You don't need any vent pipe on a biodigester. I've done videos severally explaining why people do not need vent pipes on the biodigesters. If there's an issue of scent, there must be a vent pipe on the building itself. If you are constructing or you are building your house, ensure the plumber has got a vent pipe on the building. The vent pipes are ideally or usually made for the toilet seats, so that any toilets that get stuck in it, it takes the scent away all the way out. If a biodigester is constructed wall, there is not going to be any scent coming out from the biodigester. So the top slabs have been put on it. We are also leaving room for an inspection chamber by putting a clean out on it, so that the homeowner can have access to it. He can open it and see if he's in doubt whether the digester is working or is not working. So this is the digging for the Soakaway, the traditional Soakaway itself being done. And we are going to lay the blocks for that one as well. The Soakaway must be such that the gradient or the leachate pipe, as it's been connected here, goes into it. And there's a room. There's enough room for the water to come. We are leaving spaces inside the Soakaway for the wastewater to seep out into the earth surface. Any excess one can be retained in it. And if the ground is even a waterlogged area, then you can put a pump on it and have the water pumped out during the rainy season. During the dry season, the water will always seep out because it's only toilet water you are managing at this point in time. There's no kitchen water. This is the biodigester plus the Soakaway, traditional Soakaway that have been done for this particular property. So we got to develop this type of biodigester construction after doing a few of them and then realizing that you have to raise the biodigester from the bed, and then you don't want it to disappear completely, because when the groundworks are done, it's possible that the digester will be lost. And you don't want your digester to get lost. You want your digester to be seen in a house. When you show up in the compound for maintenance or to go and do any correction, you want to see your digester showing at a place. If not the complete digester, at least some parts, the top slab or something should be showing, just to let you know that my digester is here.